Are you serious? Are you serious? I want to know. Because I'm serious. If you're serious, then we're all serious. Welcome to the coming apocalypse. I'm Pastor Paul Begley, and I am serious. Right. We're all serious. Welcome to the coming apocalypse. I'm Pastor Paul Begley. We are live on Thursday night. Prime time, live, and it's going to be a powerful broadcast with Mike from around the world. Planet X, is it 2 weeks away? Is it 2 weeks away? That is the question people are trying to ask. That is the situation that we see developing. Is it 2 weeks away? I really think, I mean, it's hard to imagine that. But we got Mike from the world. Remember Gil Brizard. Remember all these different people who've been talking about the arrival. Now, Mike did not guarantee it. Let me just go on the record right now. He did not. We will play what he said last week. But he said it's very possible. But soon, everyone is going to see it, okay? And we'll play that for you in just a second. Let me put a shout-out right now for www.noblegoldinvestment.com. That's www.noblegoldinvestment.com. The U.S. dollar has lost 85% of its value since the 70s when the dollar decoupled from gold. And, or in other words, we've been off the gold standard. And the government seems bent on continuing this tradition. From now until after the election, the government can print as much money as they want. The last time they did that, inflation went up 9%. That was during the Obama administration. Gold is the one asset that is proven to withstand the inflation. Invest in gold with NobleGoldInvestment.com. That's www.NobleGoldInvestment.com. Or pick up the phone and call them at 877-646-5347. Folks, you could get this 24-carat, one-quarter of an ounce gold standard coin. They will send you a one-quarter of an ounce gold standard coin, 24-carat, for free. If you set up a gold or silver IRA qualifying, you can have this. Just find out more about it. Let them talk you through it. NobleGoldInvestment.com. That's www.noblegoldinvestment.com. All right. Now, guys, seriously, tonight, Mike Friend of the World is going to bring forth some shocking revelations. No doubt about that. I've still been thinking about last Thursday night's broadcast with him about this Planet X being possibly, again, he didn't guarantee it, possibly 2 weeks away. Incredible. When you think about it, just when you just think about it. Oh, before I get started, I just get this out of the way right now. Tonight's special offer, and we don't do this every Thursday night, you know, but occasionally we do. Occasionally we do. And tonight we are doing it. It's Concerned. That's right, Concerned. If you want this, maybe some of you don't have this in DVD. Some of you may not even watch the webinar when it came out. Maybe you didn't have the opportunity to. But if you want to see the entire 7-DVD set with Stan Deo, Doug Hagman, Larry Ragland, Rex Baer, Mike from around the world, myself, and Bart Begley's documentary, it's unbelievable. Your love gift of $45 or more, you don't even have to order it. Just send a love gift tonight of $45 or more. I will send this to you in the mail. It just automatically will get shipped, headed in your direction. So, wow, I just want you to know it's a powerful, powerful webinar. Actually, Stan Deo, The New World Order, Mark of the Beast. Mike from the world, the end has come. Mike from the world, the end has come. Doug Hagman, Dangers of a World Economic Forum. Dangers of the World Economic Forum. Bishop Larry Ragland, CERN and the World Wide Web. And that was a great presentation. And Rex Baer, CERN and the Occult Practices. Plus, my message on the Beast Kingdom and Bart Begley's documentary on CERN. Tonight, you just send your love gift in, $45 or more. I will ship that to you. You don't even have to order it. Just love gift, $45 or more. Everyone that gives $45 or more, it's coming your way. Concerned with CERN. Mike from the world's going to join us tonight. We got a lot of stuff to talk about here. We've got Israel firing back at Hezbollah in Lebanon. It's just unbelievable. The webinar that's coming out. The webinar. Heidi just booked three powerful guests, and there's more to add. But Avi Loeb, the Harvard professor who's big time in the news now because he went down there into the Pacific Ocean, and they went down to the bottom of the ocean and found 50 perfectly round spheres, metal spheres, that he says come from an extraterrestrial crash in the ocean. And they spent $1.5 million going out there and scouring the bottom of the ocean and found 50 perfectly round metal spheres. And these spheres are exotic metal from another world, okay? So Avi Loeb, of course, he's the one, he wrote a book entitled, it was about Uma Uma, when that Uma Uma came through, and he said that was not, that was an interstellar spacecraft from alien forms. We're going to have him. We're going to let him speak. He's going to be one of our guests on this next webinar coming up, Aliens Above and Below. We also, Heidi also locked down L.A. Marzulli today. He will be one of our guests with some incredible information that he has just recently uncovered. And Rex Baer has confirmed, and he has just unleashed some brand new information also. Plus, we've got other guys we're going after, big ones, okay? So we're off and running. Mike Brown the World, Avi Lipkin, L.A. Marzulli, Rex Baer, and we're shooting for two or three more heavy hitters that we hope to get on the broadcast with us. We're trying to get Stan Deo. We're trying to get a guy from off Ancient Aliens on the History Channel. We're trying to get him, giving him a shot. You know, so we're kind of mixing it up, to be fair. So unbelievable. Robo Mom is in the house. Okay, so just know that that's coming. We'll let you know more about upcoming webinar called Aliens Above and Below. And you can already get your tickets pre-ordered if you go to Eventbrite and just look up Aliens Above and Below, okay? And you'll find over there, okay? Oh, and if you want to order tonight, if you want to place an offering, your love gift of $45 or more, you can go to the website and just hit the donate button and do it. Or you can pick up the phone even and call the main office. Yeah, and where's that at? Yeah, you can just call the main office, which is 765-414-2230. And you can order webinar tickets there. You can get the Concern DVD, you know, whatever you want by placing a love gift. And so, you know, it's up to you, okay? But we just want you to know that is available. And it's just going to be an amazing night tonight. Well, let's get started. Let's dig in because Mike from around the world is going to join us tonight. We've got so much to talk about, but he kicked the thing off by talking about Planet X. We may be going to see Planet X within 2 weeks. He said possibly. He did not guarantee that, but it won't be long. His words, it won't be long. A binary system will be seen. It will not be long, folks. Wow. But before we do that, I thought we got a ton of stuff to talk about tonight, including is Robert RFK Jr., Robert Kennedy, is it possible that he might be Donald Trump's running mate? A Republican and a Democrat teaming up together, Trump and Kennedy, both their families, not a part of the Illuminati at all. Matter of fact, Robert Kennedy's father was assassinated. He was going to win the election in 68. And his brother, John F. K., was assassinated in the White House. We know this. So Robert Kennedy Jr., his father and uncle both, and I don't agree with a lot of his politics, but I do know that he's an honest guy who cares about America and can't stand the New World Order. So is it possible? We have not had a Republican president with a Democrat vice president since Abraham Lincoln and Andrew Johnson. Are you serious? Are you serious? But before we even get into this discussion with all these things, I got to play this. Oh, yeah. When the White House has claims they found too much drugs and cocaine. Cocaine. They said it was in a secured location at the Situation Room. Cocaine. Cocaine. Near Harris's car in the parking lot. Cocaine. Oh, my Lord, have mercy. Yeah. Well, it's true, guys. The Biden White House cocaine scandal is really heating up. The mainstream media is all over it. The White House is now claiming the cocaine was found in a much more secure place near the Situation Room. How you like that? You want to know that the people are snorting coke when the world's in a crisis? Oh, yes. Cocaine. Well, the story about the cocaine discovery keeps changing. Tuesday night, it was reported that cocaine was stashed in a cubby, a little storage facility in the West Wing after Hunter Biden visited the White House. Nobody is accusing him of being involved in this at all. I just want to say that. Nobody. I'm not. I'm definitely not. But the cocaine was hidden in this little cubby located in a frequently trafficked place in the West Wing, not in the library as originally was reported. And the White House is claiming that the cocaine was found in a much more secure place near the Situation Room. And according to MSNBC, the bag of cocaine was found in a much more secure place near the Situation Room. We've all learned, in fact, two West Wing entrances. Now the investigation has progressed. And so they're saying the West Executive Entrance, which, as you noted, is closer to the Situation Room, which is close to the West Executive Drive, where Vice President Kamala Harris parks her car. No one is saying she's involved at all. It just so happened to be that's the area. Cocaine. Oh, man, I tell you. That's enough. It's enough already. Enough! 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 Stop it! Cocaine. Okay, that's enough. Okay? It is a very cocaine situation. And, I mean, this is about as crazy as it gets. Somebody, there's no way to know how this cocaine got in the White House, let alone close to the Situation Room. It's a very embarrassing situation for everyone involved, the Biden administration, for our federal government, for America in general. It's just, you know, we got high crime. We have a crime out of control in our major cities. Inflation, taxation, migration, frustration. We got a fentanyl problem where 100,000 people died of fentanyl drugs in the last year. We have a Congress completely spinning out of control. We have the threat of wars and rumors of wars. We have a breakdown in societal norms. we have made a mockery of God in this country. And the last thing we need to do, but think about this. We're saying a lot of drugs are now legal. A lot of things that are just let it all slide. So why is the mainstream, lamestream fake news media? And I have to tell you this, it isn't Fox. Fox just laughs. I mean, I was watching this morning, CNN, MSNBC, the Wall Street Journal, the New York Times, the Washington Post, the Huffington Post, all of these guys are all freaking out over this cocaine. Are you serious? I mean, there's a whole lot more stuff going on than a little bag of cocaine in the White House. We've got trafficking going on of human beings. We have the secrets of this nation somehow being sold out to other nations, including China. We're on the brink of global thermal nuclear war from major nations. William is right. This is just another distraction to keep us from what's really going on in this nation that is suffering with lack of focus. We have a broken down society right now, guys. It's just crazy, the things that's going on. Matter of fact, speaking of things that are a little bit crazy, the United Nations have proposed a seven-year plan, prophetically significant. The UN recently has announced that they have a seven-year accelerated plan for transformation action to achieve SDG. What is SDG? No, it's not a communicable. No, it's Sustainable Development Goals. The UN put this in place, and now they've intended to establish a one-world government, or at least something that looks pretty close to it, within the next 7 years. Below is a quote. The SDG summit in September of 2023 that's coming up must signal a genuine turning point. It must mobilize the political commitment and breakthroughs of our world desperately needs. It must deliver a rescue plan for people and this planet. This is what the UN is saying. At the center of this rescue plan, the heads of state and government must recommit to 7 years of an accelerated, sustained, transformative action, both nationally and internationally, to develop and deliver on the promise of the SDG. Leaders can show their resolve by adopting an ambitious, forward-looking political declaration of the SDG summit and presenting global and national commitments for the SDG transformation, Sustainable Development Goals, SDG. They are now pushing for this coming United Nations meetings in September to force this seven-year goal to global sustainability. Those that deny the restoration, in fact, the globalists of our day are thinking in terms of 7 years. Isn't that a prophetic number? And those who believe that the 70 weeks of Daniel chapter 9, verse 24 through 27, remain relevant for our day would answer yes. A United Nations seven-year plan is extremely prophetically significant. Are we in the seven-year, 70-week, if you will, the 70-week of Daniel? I don't believe this is the seven-year tribulation period has begun yet, although there are some who are already starting to question it, already starting to ask that question. I think I will address it extremely well. I'm going to be honest with you. Troy Anderson, my co-author, and I, we just had another hour and a half meeting and of things we want to add to the book as we're finishing writing it, even though it's already, you can pre-order today. But there's things we're putting in that are happening as we speak that we're getting in last minute changes because prophecy is updating on minute to minute situation. And so we're headed, guys, we are headed to a new world order. We are headed, and you've heard presidents, not John F. Kennedy, because he was not part of the secret societies and he was not a part of the Illuminati, and they assassinated him. But every president since then has endorsed the new world order, except Donald Trump, who is also not part of it. So wouldn't that be something if Trump and Robert Kennedy Jr., JFK was not a part of the Illuminati or the New World Order, and they killed him. Every president after JFK has endorsed it in speeches. We can play them if you want me to. I can go to YouTube right now, and I can play every one of them. Every one of them, especially George H.W. Bush, then Reagan. Excuse me, George W. Bush was really the main one. The other guys, Reagan mentioned it. Carter believed in it. Ford was a part of it. Nixon was certainly in it. And then when you get past George H.W. Bush, Bill Clinton preached about it. George W. Bush gave speeches on it. Barack Obama proclaimed it. Joe Biden even gave 13 speeches about it while he was vice president. Donald Trump hated it. And Joe Biden wants to lead it. And that's just the way it is. I mean, so I'm not saying anything new. I mean, I'm not, this is, that's the words out of their own mouth. So we know that they're heading that direction. It's quite amazing. Late storms tonight are hitting in Colorado. The weather is treacherous out there, dangerous. Pray for people living in Colorado, Kansas, Nebraska, and the next couple days, sweeping into Oklahoma, Missouri, Tennessee, southern Illinois, southern Indiana, maybe Kentucky, as this cool front coming down, meeting this heat coming out of Florida, collide and create straight line winds of 90 miles an hour, tornadic activity, and hail, 2 and 3 inches of hail, some hail the size of baseballs are anticipated, along with several tornadoes. We just have to pray for everyone in the path of this thing. We're truly living in dangerous times. We really, really are. And then Israel. Israel has attacked southern Lebanon because southern Lebanon fired 2 rockets, one which exploded in Israel. Israel not happy about this, so they retaliated. Israel's already been cleaning out the terrorists out of the West Bank, especially in the city of Yanin. They've already dealt with Nablus, and now they're dealing with Yanin. And 12 Palestinian terrorists were killed, over 100 people injured. Then rockets come flying out of Gaza, and then rockets come flying out of Lebanon, both of which Israel has responded by the IDF firing back at the locations from which those missiles were fired, taking care of that situation. So this is really getting closer and closer and closer to some serious, very serious. Psalms 83, even Ezekiel 38. We're so close. When you have the 3 nations, Turkey, Russia, and Iran, who have built a coalition, you got to be worried about it. Russia is going to continue to dominate the global scene right now. They're not leaving Ukraine. They have no intention of leaving Ukraine. And they're not going to leave Syria. Matter of fact, Russia is going to continue to dominate the global and world headlines. Four of the five places mentioned in Ezekiel 38, Gog, the Ezekiel 38, Gog and Magog coalition are players in all of this. The Wagner Group was a very active in Libya, and it says Libya is one of the five. Also, the nations of Iran, Turkey, and Russia, all four of them have formed a coalition against Israel. The only one left is Ethiopia, and really, that's just a Ethiopia used to be Sudan, and South Sudan used to all be part of Ethiopia. Well, those guys have already declared a hatred toward Israel. So, and then there's other nations. There's these that we already know, the big three: Russia, Iran, and Turkey. And then we know the others, and even a few more, are all coming together in what could be the beginning of Gog and Magog. We're going to watch it very closely. I'm telling you, we are in the last days. Speaking of the Wagner Group, Prigozhin has returned to Russia, according to Belarus President Lukashenko. Belarus President Lukashenko says the head of the mercenary group behind the failed mutiny in St. Petersburg, Prigozhin, has went back to Russia. What? This don't make sense. This guy was going to go marching in, and then he left, and now he's back. Yes, darling?
I have the tour link
up. Oh, you do?
Yes.
The tour that we got having?
I'll send it to you.
Okay, let me grab it. Hang on 1 second. Just send it to me. Ha-ha, here it is. Right here? Which one? That one there or this one? And this one's
just a brochure.
Okay. So I should click here and then I should grab that, right? Okay, I can do that. Well, thank you, Heidi. You're amazing.
Thank you.
So okay, guys, here's a link. The tour, the cruise that we're gonna do in 2024. Apostle Paul's journey. There's a link to it. It's an incredible tour. It's called the Land of the Bible Tour with Pastor Paul Begley. It'll be on the Odyssey cruise ship of the seas starting September 2nd through September 15th. It's a phenomenal tour. We'll leave the United States on September 2nd. We'll arrive in Rome on September 3rd, and we will get on the ship from Rome. We will disembark on September 4th in Naples and go see Pompeii and Mount Vesuvius, and on and on and on. We'll wind up, guys, going to Greece, going to Corinth. We'll go to Mars Hill. We're going to go to, it's an unbelievable trip. And we do end up going to the Holy Land. We even wind up at the Sea of Galilee. We end up going to Capernaum. We go to where Jesus fed the 5,000. We spend the night in Tiberias. And the next day we go to Jerusalem. We go to the Mount of Olives. We go to the Church of Holy Sepulchre. We walk the Via della Rosa. We go to the high priest Caiaphas' home where Jesus was held and imprisoned. And then we go back and get on the boat and sail back into the Mediterranean, back to Greece again. And we have all these different stops. So anyway, it's September 2nd through September 15th of 2024, not this year, next year. So we do stop in the Holy Land. And I'll be able to take all those prayer requests to the wall. We do stop in the Holy Land, but we also start in Rome and go to Greece. And so we're Italy, Greece, some of the other islands like Crete, some of the places where Paul preached. We wind up even in Israel before getting back on the boat and finishing our trip. So everyone's invited. I hope there's limited seating on this one, so you'll want to find out about it. And I think Heidi told me that if you want to reserve your seat to be on this incredible trip with Paul and Heidi, you got to put $250 down. That's all you got to put down. And then you got time to pay it off, okay? So it's next September 2024 is when we're leaving, and you need to get your seats booked now. It's really your cabin, your room in on the ship, okay? Find out about that link. I just put it there. I'll put it there one more time, and maybe the mods can grab that. Here it is. And that's the link right there. Okay. So Mike Around the World is going to join us tonight. Matter of fact, before we go to the break, I would like to play this. Listen, this is from last week. This is from last week. When am I going to wear the Kansas Jayhawk hat? Hang on a second. Are you serious? You're asking me this question? Okay. Well, I wear a lot of hats here. Okay, I got the Israeli Defense Forces hat, but that's not the one you want me to wear, right? Israeli Defense Forces? No, you don't. It's not blue. It's green, really, but it doesn't really like to show up that way. I have an LSU hat, LSU Tigers. Is that okay? I know I'm wearing a Florida Gator shirt. I know. Calm down. You don't want the LSU hat? Okay. I got the Alabama hat, Roll Tide. Want that one? No? Okay. All right. Well, what about, is it okay if I wear the Dogs? They're the national champions. The Georgia Dogs. No, you don't want that? Okay. How about the Jacksonville Jaguars that go to the NFL? Is that okay? No? No, you don't like that either? Come on. What about the North Carolina hat? Tar Heels. Is that okay? No? Come on. What about the Tennessee Volunteers? Go Vols. No? What about the Mike from Around the World hat? What? Sorry. How about the Jackie Robinson hat? No? How about In God We Trust? No? What else do I got over here? Where's my Kansas Jayhawk? What about Armageddon? No? You don't want that one either, huh? Okay. But Kansas is in Indiana. Sorry. My Kansas hat and my Purdue hat and my Indiana and my Notre Dame hat and Montana. I think Montana. And those are in Indiana. So I got a bunch. People send me these. And if you want me to wear your favorite team, you just send me your hat. But I'm so sorry. The Kansas Jayhawk hat is in Indiana. Okay, so I can't wear it. All right? I can't wear it. So sorry about that. We'll try to work on getting that back when we can. I'll be right back. No. I'm not going anywhere. I got to play this. This is Mike from Around the World from last Thursday. This is why we're talking about Planet X. I want you to hear Mike, his own words. Mike, if I play it there, does that play through here? I don't, does it? Uh-oh. Give me 1 second. I forgot public the technology here. So Give me a second. I can do this. I can do this. I think. Oh, boy. Paul Begley. You should have known this. You should have had this together. Well, I did. I had it together up there, but I forgot that you can't do it that way. So you do it this way, which I can do. Give me a moment. No. No, no, no. Okay. Okay, I'm real close. Okay, here we go. Mic around the world. Last week.
As it is, if you looked at some of the fire tracks going all the way down to South America, China, Mongolia, Kazakhstan, Russia, Australia, there are fires all over the place. Canada is just one example that has drawn attention, but fires are beginning all over the place.
Wow. Well, I know Indiana. I was just up there. It didn't rain for 3 weeks. Now, after I left, it rained Sunday, and it got a little bit of rain Tuesday. But, I mean, it did not rain for 3 weeks. The grass, everybody's grass was brown. There was nothing green. The crops were suffering. So if a fire was to break loose in that country, it'd be outrageous.
You know, I think it will because of the fourth and the way people are. I believe that something not so good will take place. People are not very responsible with fireworks, and some people underestimate just how fast these fires can begin.
Amen to that.
Yeah.
So, Mike, also with the fire map, as you've been talking about here, and the smoke and the plume and all that choking us out, and it's not good for our health, we know that. There was, again, how can we have tornadoes on top of mountains? Can you help me understand that? They never have heard of this. Montana, and now Wyoming.
Well, if you start looking at some of the systems that are going around the Earth and some of the past stabilities that we have, you'll notice a steep change in ocean temperatures, number one. That's a driver of storms. That's a main driver. In our atmosphere, we have disturbances. Everybody's going to be aware of certain disturbances that we're having in the atmosphere, and it's not caused by anything natural that we know of.
What?
But I think that everybody's going to be well versed in weird things here shortly. But
wait a minute.
We have influencing.
You said it's not caused by natural.
No, it's not natural.
Something else is going.
Yes, not natural. Not natural. We've never had this. We've never had what. What people will see with their own eyes, nobody has ever seen something like that. Not in living times. It's not in written history, not that we know of. And so, it's going to be something that will, it's going to definitely give people a moment of pause. And they'll begin to realize that we live in a very different time, in a very different world. People will see it day in and day out. In fact, they'll start seeing
day in and day out.
Day in and day out. But this in particular will absolutely change the minds of so many. But it will also saturate the internet with a bunch of self-made experts. And of course,
right.
It's not going to be a good thing, but that naturally happens. But that's right around the corner, fastball. That's
what?
Not, that could honestly be within, a few days two weeks or something like that. It could honestly, it's that close.
Okay, are we talking about like something coming from the heavens, like the binary system that we've been talking about, or are we?
Well, it could do with it. It does. It has to do with the binary system.
Okay,
certain things that people have talked about that have been theory. Well, they're not going to be theory here too much longer. Every child, every person, every adult, everybody's going to see it all the time. And so
every child, every person, everybody's going to see it all the time. It could be as soon as 2 weeks away. And he said that a week ago. Now, he didn't guarantee that, but he definitely let us know that this thing is serious. Can I just hear that again just for a second, Mike? That is so hard to do that. You know, hurricanes, outrageous typhoons. So we've been following along this path, but I'm hearing you say it's close to where everyone will see it, and it ain't.
Oh, yeah.
It's not of this world.
No. No, it isn't. It will change. It'll change. It'll change everything. People will just have to get used to it.
Will people literally get afraid and die from it?
I think they will. I think that it's happened, you know, a similar thing. Well, not similar to this, but people have seen less, and they have, you know, their hearts couldn't take it. And it's unfortunate, especially as believers, because believers read the Bible, and we know what the Lord said. But it's almost like, Pastor Paul, we talk about subjects, but the general populace, they're not really expecting anything to upset their world. For example, they see the government's going all over the place, right? Things are not going right. And of course, in the Bible, we see a realignment of governmental structure and power. We see things working differently. But one of the issues is people, they don't like change. And a lot of people, well, they don't want to talk about nor know about things that are happening like that.
I'm going to take that back just a hair, because he said this.
Yeah, but that's right around the corner, fastball. That's not, you know, that could honestly be within, you know, a few days or two weeks or something like that. It could honestly, it's that close.
Okay, are we talking about like something coming from the heavens, like the binary system that we've been talking about, or are we?
Well, it could do with it. It does. It has to do with the binary system.
Okay.
Certain things that people have talked about that have been theory. Well, they're not going to be theory here too much longer. Every child, every person, every adult, everybody's going to see it all the time. And so.
What? So you're saying we're 2 weeks. Are we? We possibly could be 2 weeks away for this.
Well, it could be. It depends, you know. Nobody can control what's happening.
Okay.
It's totally out of man's control. Nobody's controlling that. But it is certainly influencing everything on the planet at this point.
Wow. Okay. Every person, every child, everyone are going to see it. It could be as close as 2 weeks away. Don't know, but it's going to happen soon. So, we're going to ask Mike, I got swamped with emails from people from that 2 minute segment where Mike divulged that. Now, Mike's been talking about this Planet X, Nibiru, Planet Number 9, the binary system, the dwarf star, whatever you want to call it, since 2014 on the air live with me. Periodically for 8 years, and going on nine years. But now we're talking about, it's not a theory, it's reality, and it could be as close as 2 weeks away. People are going to be making they're going to see it. People are going to see. They're going to wonder what it is. Apparently, the YouTubers are going to make up all kinds of theories. He said that'd be dangerous. I'm sure the government's going to come up with all kinds of theories. That'd even be more dangerous. It won't harm us, apparently, because we see it, but what's coming with it could be catastrophic. And so we have to start asking ourselves a couple questions. How close are we? How close are we to the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ? Because he said that there'll be signs in the sun, the moon, the stars, distress of nations with perplexity. The sea and the waves will be roaring. And men's hearts are going to fail them for fear. For looking after those things that are coming upon the earth, for the powers of heaven are going to be shaken. I'll be right back. Mike from around the world. Planet X update. Is it 2 weeks away? And what else is going on, Mike? Are you serious? People are not ready for Jesus Christ to come. They're not ready.
God, I'm so scared. for this crooked generation. You even find faith in the earth when you bring down revelation. Forgive us now the sins of our youth, worshiping the idols that knew everything but the truth. Teach us how to uncorrupt our minds. Show us now while we still have the time. We need you, Yeshua. Holy, holy. We need you, Yeshua. Holy, holy, hallelujah. We abandon everything to follow you, our King. We throw our gold and silver in the stream.
How much will we see before the fire falls? Lord, could this really be the last altar call? We need your blood over the doorposts of our hearts. Anoint us with your fiery love as the praise and worship starts. Yeshua, holy, holy, hallelujah.
We need you,
Yeshua. Holy, holy, hallelujah.
We abandon everything to follow you, our King. We throw our gold and silver in the streets. Oh, we abandon everything
to follow you, our King. We throw our gold and silver in the streets. He's coming, folks. Jesus Christ, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, is coming. Will you be ready when he comes?
We abandoned everything to follow you, our King. We throw our gold and silver in the stream.
Abandon everything to follow you, our King. We throw our gold and silver in the stream. Powerful song. Israel Hall wrote it, and he helped me sing it. That's on my album, Harmonize, Prophesy. Guys, seriously, you may have heard of Alex Soros. I don't know if you have, but he's George Soros's son, and he is now, at the age of 37, he is now taking over the Soros Open Society Foundation, which is worth $25 billion. Alex Soros, the 37-year-old son of George Soros, who recently took control of the mammoth multi-billion-dollar Open Society Foundation, has now, it's been reported, he has visited the White House 20 times since Joe Biden was elected. You heard me right. The records show George Soros' son, Alex Soros, and all of his, on all those agendas that you know Soros is behind, all of that corruption, all of that global elitism, he's turned it over to his son. And his son has visited the White House 20 times since Joe Biden became president. Benjamin Netanyahu has not been there yet. He tried to go, and Biden told him to stay home. But Alex Soros has been there 20 times. Matter of fact, in late March, Alex attended three meetings with Nina Srivastava, who previously served as the advisor for Biden's former chief of staff, Ron Klain. And also he met with Amanda Sloat, the National Security Council's senior director for Europe. And he met with John Finer, the principal deputy national security advisor, according to recently released visitor logs. Why is this guy at the White House meeting with top security people? Alex has been to the White House now 20 times since Joe Biden took office. Alex is even more radical than his father. And he says that he announced on June 11th that Alex is taking over. George Soros says Alex is taking over the network. Since then, he's been jet-setting around the world, meeting with top Democrat officials, including former President Bill Clinton. And he even had a meeting with the Pope of Rome in France, Pope Francis. Shortly after the announcement, Alex hosted an event featuring House Minority Leader Hakeem Jeffries and other top New York Democrats, including Jerry Nadler, Gregory Meeks, and others. Back in New York, minute to host a distant member of the New York for members of the New York House delegation. He met with Pat Ryan, Richie Torres. Alex, meanwhile, spent the 4th of July in Albania with former President Bill Clinton. I mean, think about this. Why is Bill Clinton in Albania on the 4th of July with Alex Soros? Does anybody get a clue on that one? What a treat for the Clinton for President Clinton in Albania, Alex wrote. One of the most pro-American countries in the world and a stalwart ally thanks to part of its prime minister, who's coincidentally born on the 4th of July also. Great to spend today with an American hero, Bill Clinton. He's one of my best friends in Albania. Albania. So, I mean, just saying, if you want to know, you know, I'm not, the cocaine in the White House, that's a distraction. That means nothing. Who cares? But Alex Soros meeting 20 times with top White House officials in the White House, when you know the agenda of the Soros clan, stunning. Stunning, to say the least. Back to RFK Jr. saying, I'm proud that President Trump likes me. This report just came out. There is rumors that Trump, who's way ahead in the polls on the Republican side, and Robert F. Kennedy Jr. is running about 22% on the Democrat side behind Biden, but Biden continues to slip. Kennedy not expected to get the nomination for the Democrats. There is conversation now that Trump may pick Kennedy if he wins the nomination as his running mate. It'd be the first time a Republican and a Democrat would be together since Abraham Lincoln and Andrew Johnson did it back in 1860. Robert F. Kennedy Jr. refused to criticize former President Trump last night and said he was flattered by recent comments that Trump praised him as a common sense guy. Asked by the moderator, Elizabeth Vargas, what Kennedy thinks about Trump, Kennedy said, I'm not going to attack other people personally. He then went to step further, expressing pride that he has received positive affirmations recently from President Donald Trump, who's embroiled in legal troubles as the leading Republican presidential contender for the GOP primary. He also referred to the former president as in present tense. I'm proud that President Trump likes me, he said. Trump was the latest figures on the right to defend RFK Jr. in an appearance this week on the Howie Carr Show. Hang in there, Trump advised Robert Kennedy. He said he's been very nice to me. I've actually had a very nice relationship with him over the years. He's a very smart guy, a very good guy. He's a common sense guy, and so am I. So whether you're conservative or liberal, common sense is common sense. So Kennedy, avoiding the opportunity to criticize Trump, instead thanked the president for liking him and said, if we're ever going to find common ground, maybe we have to come together. What does that mean? He also declined to comment that he was supporting President Biden if he loses. He declined to say anything about that. But he did say, we've got to stop hating each other. Some Democrats are worried that Kennedy could run as an independent in the general election, which would pull down the votes from Biden and help Trump win the election. Kennedy's approach to Trump is markedly different approach than Biden and the majority of Democrats who cast the former president as a threat to the Constitution and democracy. But Kennedy brings a whole different perspective to the whole situation. I don't know. I'm just saying, I don't think that's really going to happen. I don't think so. I would be shocked out of my mind. I would just be shocked out of my mind. But the simple fact that they're both talking positive about each other and the rumors that are swirling makes people wonder, is it possible that a Trump-Kennedy ticket might be coming in 2024? I want to read from the Bible in the book of Revelation. Mike from the world's going to join us any moment and talk about Planet X and a whole lot of other stuff. I can't wait. Oh, and Heidi just booked Avi Loeb, the Harvard professor who says that the Uma, about 4 years ago, Uma was a alien spacecraft, and now has just recently, just a week and a half ago, was down in the Pacific Ocean and found those 50 spears. And we told you guys about that last week. We even showed them to you. 50 spears of exotic metals that came from another universe somewhere. He found 50. They're perfectly round metals, and they were on the bottom of the ocean, of which he said came from a alien craft that crashed into the ocean. Now, we've heard Mike from the world say that we're seeing more and more activity, entities coming out of the ground and going, or maybe coming out of the water and going back into the water. And Mike even made mention of Leviathan's kingdom may be about to raise its head. Well, this sea creature did show up. Unbelievable. This is what's called a gulper eel. What? Look at this thing. A gulper eel. It's from the bottom of the ocean. And it was spotted. As Mike said, soon you'll see weird creatures rising up. Matter of fact, 50 sharks just off the coast of New York yesterday. That's insane, okay? But we're seeing weird things going on. Monday was the hottest day in the history of this planet. The hottest day ever in the history of the planet was Monday. So you start wondering just what's next, okay? Just what's next? How close are we to the coming of Jesus Christ? Let me read here because Planet X, or Nibiru, or Planet Number 9, or whatever you want to call it. But anyway, Heidi got Avi Loeb, and he is going to be one of the speakers in this upcoming webinar, Aliens Above and Below. You can get your tickets tonight over at Eventbrite, or you can pick up the phone and call and get your tickets tonight. Or you can call and get your, and if you want to get, anybody that goes tonight to my website and gives a donation of $45 or more, I'm going to ship you this right here, this incredible webinar concerned. With Stan Dales, New World Order, Mark of the Beast. What an interview. Mike from Around the World, the end has come. Wow. Doug Hagman, dangers of the World Economic Forum. Larry Ragland, CERN and the World Wide Web. Rex Baer, CERN and occult practices. Bart Begley's documentary on CERN. And I give you a presentation on the Beast Kingdom. These things are all in this 7-DVD webinar. You can have it. Special offer tonight through Sunday night. Special offer tonight, $45 or more. We will just automatically send you this DVD. I want you to have it. I really do. The Bible says in Revelation chapter 8, and when he opened the seventh seal, there was silence in heaven about the space of a half hour. And I saw seven angels which stood before God, and to them were given seven trumpets. And another angel came and stood at the altar, having a golden censer. There was given unto him much incense, that he should offer it with the prayers of all saints upon the golden altar, which was before the throne. And the smoke of the incense, which came with the prayers of the saints, ascended up before God out of the angel's hand. And the angel took the censer and filled it with the fire of the altar and cast it into the earth. And there were voices and thunderings and lightnings and an earthquake. And the seven angels, which had the seven trumpets, prepared themselves to sound. And the first angel sounded, and there followed hail and fire mingled with blood. And they were cast upon the earth. And a third part of the trees was burned up. And all the green grass was burned up. And the second angel sounded as it were a great mountain, burning with fire, was cast into the sea and had life. The third part of the creatures which were in the sea and had life, they died. Oh, excuse me. When the second angel was sounded, it were a great mountain burning with fire, was cast into the sea, and the third part of the sea became blood. Excuse me. And the third part of the creatures which were in the sea and had life died. And a third part of the ships were destroyed. This is huge. And the third angel sounded, and there fell a great star from heaven, burning as it were a lamp. And it fell upon the third part of the rivers and upon the fountains of waters. And the name of that star is called Wormwood. And many men died of the waters because they were made bitter, poisonous, radiation. And the fourth angel sounded, and a third part of the sun was smitten, and a third part of the moon, and a third part of the stars, so as the third part of them were darkened, and the day shone not for a third part of it, and the night likewise. And I beheld, and I heard an angel flying through the midst of heaven, saying with a loud voice, woe, woe, woe to the inhabitants of the earth, by reason of the other voices of the trumpet of the three angels, which are yet to sound. So we get this first trumpet, and we see a devastating deep impacts, two deep impacts. One looked like a burning mountain, one looked like a burning star. And that one even had a name called Wormwood. A lot of people are considering this binary system behind me as, they call it Planet X, you know, Zechariah Sitchin called it Planet X. Emmanuel Velikovsky, in his book, Worlds in Collision, called it Planet X. NASA called it Planet X until 1992, and then they didn't want to talk about it no more. But two of NASA's, or Caltech, I should say, two of Caltech's brightest scientists watch are in Hawaii right now on that observatory, and they stare into the stars looking for Planet X every night. They've been doing it for 3 years. This binary system that seems to be shaking the heavens is about to become visible. According to Mike from around the world, it's about to become visible. We are on the brink. You know, when the Bible says, for there shall be signs in the sun, we had a solar flare two nights ago, X-class one, unbelievable, exploded. The sun is incredible. The waters, the ocean waters are the hottest they've ever been in the history of this planet, folks. The temperature on the earth Monday was the hottest it's been in the history of the world. We had an earthquake in Turkey this year, killing over 50,000 people. But that is nothing compared to the events that are about to unfold on this planet, according to Bible prophecy and according to scientists and theorists who believe that we're about to be shaken. And Jesus even said, there'll be signs in the sun, the moon, the stars, and distress of nations with perplexity, and the sea and the waves will be roaring. And men's hearts are going to fail them for fear, for looking after those things coming upon the earth, for the power of heaven shall be shaken. Then it says we're going to see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. And when these things begin to come to pass, he said, look up, lift up your head. Your redemption is drawing nigh. How close are we, folks? How close are we to the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ? I'll play for you just a couple minutes here of what Mike said last week. He'll be joining us any moment. And it's incredible, really. But wow, we're in the end times, guys. We're absolutely in the end times. And it's just so evident. It's so many different levels. You there's so many different ways that you know you're in the end times. Check this out.
It's something not
else.
Natural.
Something else,
yeah,
is going.
Not natural. Not natural. We've never had this. We've never had what people will see with their own eyes. Nobody has ever seen something like that. Not in living times. It's not in written history. Not that we know of. And so, yeah, it's going to be something that will, it's going to definitely give people a moment of pause. They'll begin to realize that we live in a very different time, in a very different world. People will see it day in and day out. In fact, they'll start seeing a lot of things day in and day out.
Day in and day out.
In particular, will absolutely change the minds of so many. But it will also saturate the internet with a bunch of self-made experts. And of course,
right,
it's not going to be a good thing, but no, that naturally happens. Yeah, but that's right around the corner, fastball. That's not, you know, that could honestly be within, you know, a few days or two weeks or something like that. It could honestly, it's that close.
Okay, are we talking, you know, about like something coming from the heavens, like the binary system that we've been talking about, or are we something?
Well, it could do with it. It has to do with the binary system.
Okay,
certain things that people have talked about that have been theory. Well, they're not going to be theory here too much longer. Every child, every person, every adult, everybody's going to see it.
What?
Time. And so,
so you're saying we're 2 weeks? Are we possibly could be 2 weeks away for this?
Well, it could be. It could be. It depends. You know, nobody can control what's happening.
Okay.
It's totally out of man's control. Nobody's controlling that. And but it is certainly influencing everything on the planet at this point.
Wow. Okay. Well, you know, we've been talking about it, Mike, you and I have been talking about it for almost 10 years. I remember when you first brought up five waves of energy, and people just freaked out, and they said, what in the world is he talking about? Well, you told us that we would see the sun react. You told us that the waters, the oceans were going to heat up. You told us that the magma was rising. You told us that an ash and smoke environment would come, that fires would burn. You told us about the plagues that would come. We've been crustal displacement. You know, hurricanes, outrageous typhoons. So we've been following along this path, but I'm hearing you say it's close to where everyone will see it, and it ain't.
Oh, yeah.
It's not of this world.
No. No, it isn't. It will change. It'll change everything. People will just have to get used to it.
Will people literally get afraid and die from it?
I think they will. I think they will. I think that it's happened, you know, a similar thing. Well, not similar to this, but people have seen less, and they have, their hearts couldn't take it. And it's unfortunate, especially as believers, because believers read the Bible, and we know what the Lord said. But it's almost like, Pastor Paul, we talk about subjects, but the general populace, they're not really expecting anything to upset their world. For example, they see the government's going all over the place, right? Things are not going right. And of course, in the Bible, we see a realignment of governmental structure and power. We see things working differently. But one of the issues is people, they don't like change. And a lot of people, well, they don't want to talk about nor know about things that are happening like that. Likely because morality has dropped and they have so many people stressed out in their own personal situations.
Mike from the world is going to join us here any moment. That was a little bit from him last week telling us that we could be within 2 weeks of seeing Planet X. Possibly. Don't know for sure, but it is going to be soon. And every person, every child, every human being is going to see it. They're all going to see it. Now, he says there will be a lot of disinformation agents on the internet who will be, you know, experts that are going to be nuts, and they won't know what they're talking about because people will be looking for some type of way out of this. And then, so as he talks about this, now notice, in the same breath almost, he started talking about what he's going to talk about in the webinar. He said, we talk about aliens above and beneath, above and below. And he said, oh, well, we could be talking about this guy, Leviathan's kingdom. Now, Leviathan is in the Bible, definitely. God even told Job, he said, look, can you hook Leviathan and pull him out of the sea? No, you can't, but I can. He wouldn't have said that if he wasn't there. The demon of the sea. And then you got to ask yourself, what about Revelation 9 and Apollyon? He's coming out of the bottomless pit. And he's bringing a band of demons with him. And then he's going to let four more demons out of the river Euphrates. And there will be a 200 million man army, and the sixth trumpet will sound, and one third of this world will be killed. That is 2.5 billion people. You ain't seen nothing yet. So this binary system, this Planet X, Nibiru, Planet Number 9, whatever you want to call this thing, whatever it is, and whatever it's going to do to our planet, is coming. And I freaked out when I heard him say it could be 2 weeks away. He didn't say it was for sure. It could be 2 weeks. It could be 2 months. It could be 2 years. But I'm hearing Mike say it's a lot closer than that. Forget the two-year thing. We're in the ballpark. It could be as close as 2 weeks away. We are in the ballpark. So tonight we're going to say, Mike, help us understand. If we are, just saying, if it appears and we can see this thing and it's within, and we're within 2 weeks from now, and let's just say it appears, what will it look like and what will it mean and what will it do? How will it affect our planet? What is it we need to know besides the first thing? People need to give their life to Jesus Christ, first and foremost. Absolutely. Nothing else matters than being born again. But is the what can, just let's just hypothesis, let's just say that he's correct, that it just happens in 2 weeks, and that we're just 2 weeks away. Let's just say on July the 20th, this thing appears, and every person, every child, everyone can see it. What will take place from that moment on to this earth? Mike from the World is going to join us tonight in just a moment. We're going to ask him these questions because we truly are living in the last days. And we'll also ask him a little bit more about, well, I don't want to get into Leviathan's kingdom because that's what he's going to talk about in the webinar, and we better not go there. We've got enough on the table right now. Mike from the World is going to join us any second. Is America a failed state? The definition of a failed state, according to some experts, is a failed state is a political body that has disintegrated to the point where basic conditions and responsibilities of a sovereign government no longer function properly. Is that America? Mike from around the world. Are you there, Mike?
Pastor Paul, God bless you this evening.
God bless you. So glad to have you tonight. We've just kind of been focusing on, there's a lot of things going on, but, you know, like Prigozhin went back to Russia. What's that mean? Alex Soros has visited the White House 20 times since Biden went in, but Bibi is not invited. Cocaine is in the White House. Not sure how that got there. You said we'd see rare deep sea creatures. We did. It was called a gulper eel, which is a weird looking thing. We might have a Trump Robert F. Kennedy Jr. ticket. That's rumors. They both like each other. Who knows? We had an X class on the sun solar flare. X class, very powerful. Knocked out ham radios and communications in the West Coast. But the one thing we're still talking about since last Thursday is, and I played it for folks, when you said Planet X, you know, it's possible this thing could be within 2 weeks from being visualized. Can we talk tonight about what will that be like? What will we see and what will it mean?
Well, yeah, it's not within anybody's control. That's number one. So it could, I mean, literally at any time, any moment, really, any moment. So there's, that's like saying there is, take time out of the picture.
Okay.
Take it out, throw it away.
Throw it away.
Because we could, you know, we could be talking tonight and you know, somebody could spot that thing, spot something up there that everybody's going to see. It's going to be a persistent object. And of course, it comes with its own persistent objects. And so we are right there at the moment, actually, because it's outside of everybody's control. When we do see it, we're already seeing subtle changes from external forces. You know, speaking of those external forces, Pastor Paul, the South Pole Station is, you know, they're about to, they have to ramp up again. They have to get things going again for their neutrino detector, the brand new one.
Down or in the
not
south,
brand new one, but oh yeah,
South Pole.
Yeah, the Arctic station is a very complicated machine. It's a very complicated machine. The twin system to that is part of a, well, you could say it's part of a defense system, but it's also a detector, a really good detector. But and it detects more than, you know, supernovae, much more than that. But yeah, they have to get those things going because we have too many things in proximity to our solar system to worry about.
And so what will this
going
thing
to change everything?
So this equipment down in the South Pole, is it something to help neutralize what we got to deal with when it comes to Planet X?
No, we can't neutralize it. There's, no. They can't neutralize it, no. There's a strange story about the Earth. It has, of course, you know, a lot of people believe that this is the first time it's been inhabited. And so they may not be aware of the Earth has a pretty thorough history, very mysterious history. But we're dealing with more than just us, you know, with this, with the arrival of this system. We're dealing with a lot more than us. And you know, things will escalate as far as people being exposed to what the true history of Earth is. It's a shaker. It will really, you know, the governments know it. They know it's going to shake everything up, which is why they have a 2024 plan, which is why they're also prepping everything to be ready by 2024, to late 2023-24, because they have a great understanding that we're out of time, right? We're just out of time. And so some of the most, if not all of those ancient things will come back. The narrative may be a bit different than what people know. But for example, people know about national parks, right? Maybe there's a park ranger out there. They cannot tell their story. They already know that. But they are the best individuals to talk to when it comes to the Nephilim. They are the best individuals to talk to. They really are.
Really?
And, yeah, they have pictures, videos. They have all sorts of things. And, you know, governments are aware that they take pictures through their cell phones and they record things and have encounters, because those neutrino detectors, by the way, can detect neutrinos. And it just so happens when you have what people call that strange phenomena, right? The neutrino count goes up. So in the Arctic regions of the Earth, where no weapons can be, by the way, they have a vast array of detectors that they can, you know, detect this with. In fact, it's quite vast. You're dealing with these tiny little digital optical modules that have some pretty enormous capabilities, and it's 5,100 of those things buried under the ice. About I believe it goes down about almost 3,000 meters underneath the ice, right?
Now, 5,100 modules, are these little vehicles?
No, no, no. They're like, they're balls.
Okay.
They are digital optical DOMs is what they call them.
Okay.
And they're very sensitive. They can emit, they can transmit, they can also receive, right? For example, there have been... some people got it, some people didn't. When they use it, we have a large laser array there too, large one. And it's used for communications. So, because they have faster than light communications, I know it's going to make certain people mad because they only know public science, but they use lasers for communication. Large pulses of data go out. But they also vaporize the atmosphere when they do that. So they have to be careful when they use that thing. But they can disable, you know, things out there by those means. That story is going to be made available, by the way, by the end of the year. They're really pressing to get several individuals out there that actually work in that field as part of a minimal disclosure.
Is this sort of for the now, public? Is this a, in? Are we operating now in a physics? I mean, are we talking CERN? Are we talking?
Well, this is more than CERN. CERN is one thing, right? We're talking about an operational device, a big operational device which runs from a pretty unique power system.
Okay.
And, but it's there. Like, for example, in 2010, when they had that earthquake at, I believe it was Christchurch and a few more.
Yeah,
they kind of lined up.
Yep.
That was from a machine. That was not natural.
Yeah.
That was from a machine.
Well,
that's an unnatural consequence, Pascal, from each module has an ability to emit 2,100 volts or 2,100 volts of voltage, but you're talking about an obscene amount of amps coming from each module, and it's over 5,000. So,
you know,
it has.
Okay. When this happened, I covered what I called the 188-day earthquake cycle. There were 7 earthquakes that were pretty big that happened exactly on the 188th day each time. The first one was in Concepcion, Chile. It was about an 8.1 or something. Then the next one was in Christchurch, New Zealand, and it was like a 7.4. And then the third one was the one that hit Fukushima, Japan, which was a 9.1, and we know what that did. And each one of those was on the 188th day. So then I said, whoa, and I kept studying it, and seven straight times on the 188th day, there was a major earthquake. That's either God is in some kind of algorithm, or this was man-made, machine-made. Is that possible?
Well, yeah, it is, because that's a LF low frequency system, right? Everybody thinks it's HARP. HARP is more of a high altitude microwave
transmission
system,
basically.
And despite all the internet claims, internet's very dangerous when it comes to that stuff, because some of that stuff is just not real. It doesn't work the way sometimes they make devices that do not work. And HARP is a good example of that. There are other machines that are at work, and while everybody's looking at HARP, they're missing everything else anyway. So we have that detection center, which must be online prior to the end of the year. Going into 2024, and it must be online.
Why must it be online? Is it somehow to protect the Earth, or is there some role it plays?
Well, they need the communications, number one.
Okay.
You're talking about a laser, right? A laser that's the width of a house going up into space.
What? That is gigantic.
Yeah, that's big. It's green. It's big. And that's faster than light communications. The real question is, who are they communicating with? That's a real question. But at any rate, they have to have these things online 2024. Also, there's a persistent warning going out about two things. Number one, this is only coming from the government. They keep subtly telling everybody a storm is coming. And then places like New York, places like Arizona, Texas, and places like that, their power companies are on permanent standby. So what that means is we're going into a hyper season for the sun, right? Which they do expect a lot of damage. Listen to me. They do expect a lot of damage to the point where they have FEMA in certain executive orders kind of outline emergency powers taking over everything for the sake of coordination, right? When I say everything, I mean everything. These EOs, seizure and control of media, right? Electric, power, gas, petroleum, fuels, minerals, all seize all transportation, mobilize civilians into work brigades, all these different things, these EOs. Well, they have been looked at recently, right? And they also, certain permanent bills have been made up for this. Now they have the power companies permanently on standby. That makes no sense to have them permanently on standby. Why would the electric and gas be permanently on standby? Those are the two basic sources of power. But if they fail, we are in the dark, right? There's no internet without power. So, that warning also went out from the federal government that we could face a major disruption in communications this year.
Okay, so they're anticipating the sun.
Yeah,
they
are.
And we're going into a solar maximum, but I think you're saying that the sun is reacting to this binary system.
Yeah, we're talking about forces much higher than any solar cycle would ever produce. The term they use are biblical activities of the sun. We could actually see biblical activities of the sun. And of course, in the Bible, it says that the sun, when the angel poured his vial into the sun, scorched the earth, and men blasphemed God because they were scorched with it. So biblical activities from the sun, it's not going to happen all by itself. The sun is intimately tied to defense of the heliosphere, you could say. So anything outside the heliosphere is going to activate or cause the sun to react in a specific way. The sun distributes some of its power all over through all these planets. And it's a very perfect system God designed, but it's extremely reactive, right? Extremely. We had a flare not a little bit ago.
Right, right.
We also had, we were sheared by gamma ray bursts. You didn't hear that on the internet.
No, we did not. No.
So which means we're not going to be destroyed by gamma ray bursts. Isn't that funny? It actually happened. They didn't, when you don't expose things to social media, people can't get a hold of it. They can't evaluate. They don't know. They yeah. did not know, right? Now, they may have felt some heat on their bodies. The planet certainly did heat up, right?
Yeah.
But other than that.
I mean, you know that right now the oceans are the hottest they've ever been. And Monday was the hottest day in the history of the Earth. Never before. The overall temperature was 62.64. It was the hottest ever recorded. So are we already getting the effects of this, the sun and the effects it's getting from this binary system?
Actually, we're feeling minimal effects right now.
Okay.
Right? Now, but at any time, it could hit the reactive zone. A reactive zone is when all the planets and the sun begin to react to this perturber, right? At that point, the sun could double its capacity of output. Or that'd fry us. It could do a few things, right? If the sun's temperature were to, say it were to double, right? believe me, they have certain places better ready for this. Now, why in the world would reinforced concrete be used on certain highways with springs in the bottom as of 2022? Why would they do that? A highway that can withstand temperatures of about, I think it's 2,000 degrees. Right? Because normally you use rebar and all that other stuff, not in this highway, right? So you have these exotic composite materials being placed in these highways that cost millions of dollars. And nobody can tell the difference. It does not ride smoother, but it can withstand a lot of temperature. Why is most of the foods that people are eating? Something is wrong with the foods that people are eating. Something is wrong with Purina, right? Something is wrong with that stuff. And you have all these recalls, right?
Right.
You have all these change in vendors because people are starting to get wise. For example, the chicken problem.
Right.
Maybe you know about that, but a lot of chickens, were eaten feed from Purina. They would not lay eggs for about 5 to 6 months. As soon as they took the chickens off the Purina and gave it something else from the Amish, next day they started laying eggs. But they shut the Amish suppliers down. Do you know that? Shut them down 5 days after. The USDA comes and investigates all the farms that have chickens that were producing these eggs. And weird things are happening. And Bill Gates, he owns, you wouldn't believe how much he owns the farms in the USA. This guy is over 50% right now.
Wow.
He's well over 50%.
Wow.
What in the world is he doing with it? Well, as of a few months ago, they don't have to tell you that they have GMO wheat, right?
Yeah, they do.
The bread. I like what is that bread? I think it's the bread in the yellow package, pretty long loaf. I used to like that bread. I will not eat it, the sun stuff or whatever it is. Oh. It tastes wrong. It's wrong.
So the wheat's been contaminated with
wrong, Pastor Paul. It's wrong.
And let me ask you a question. You know, Sugar passed away, our dog passed away. And she got, I mean, she was 14 and a half years old, but she got sick. She got cancer, and it killed her in 10 weeks. Then our cat, Lily, got sick and withered away and died also, even in a shorter period of time, same month. I said that on the air, and people, of course, they love Sugar. She'd been with us since I was on the air, and so it's just sad. But we started getting letters, Mike, and emails.
Their pets are going to.
They're all dying of the same thing. Yeah. They get cancer and they die in 6 weeks. What's going on? Is that food or is that air or what is it?
No, Pastor Paul, we have a lot of – the sun is natural, of course, right? Nobody should ever fear the sun, believe it or not. And it's so difficult to explain certain things. Yes, the sun can cause cancer. It causes cancer because of what we ingest. Let's put it that way.
So animals
are susceptible to what we consume, to what we wear, to what we wash our clothes with, right? They are more and more, they're using all these synthetic, materials. Dogs do one thing and they do it all the time, which is sniff, right? So yeah. That's their major point of entry into the body. They also taste everything. Dogs will taste everything. Cats smell a lot of things. So they're a bit, no doubt the ratio between dogs and cats, as far as being deceased, cats die slower than dogs do, because dogs lick everything. Cats do not. We use moisturizers and all these other things, right? You wouldn't believe what's in that stuff as of 2020, the end of 2022. Everything in the manufacturing field has been altered. It's changed. Everything is. My only advice for that, because it at this point, it really doesn't matter what you do. Just pray over your animals, but I'll tell you something, basketball. Sometimes when people lose pets, it's not a bad thing, because the Lord knows what we're about to face, and some acts of mercy we don't comprehend in the beginning. But I can tell you this, to this day, I will not have a pet because of my army dog, right? I won't have a pet, no more pets for me. Because you get really attached.
Right.
But I also know the environment of the world and what we're headed into. And I can't go that route. That would slow me down. Let's put it that way. It's one of those unfortunate things.
So
it's a combination of things, you know?
Yeah. So this whole thing, this binary system is shaking up the heavens. It's causing a massive reaction by the sun. Man is trying to adjust how that's going to survive it by changing the food, the GMO makeup of the food. We've got weapons down in Antarctica that laser beams off the charts for whatever reason. And we're seeing this, and there's no escaping this, is there, Mike? There's just no escaping it. Let me ask you, we see that, we know that this election that's coming up, and I don't want to go into the political world, but we know that there's things happening in Russia. There's things happening in Israel right now that are very volatile. And we see that Trump has mentioned that he really gets along with Robert Kennedy Jr. And Kennedy says he likes Trump. And even though that we have a Republican and a Democrat, even though they're on two sides of the spectrum, these guys seem to respect each other. And they're both not part of the global elite, the secret societies.
That's a problem.
Do you see, is it possible that these guys might pull an Abraham Lincoln, Andrew Johnson move and have a Republican and a Democrat together?
Well, at any other time in history, right, I would say that would be a good thing. Here's the problem, though. The problem is the selection of presidents. For example, President Biden, he's old. He's very old. He's fragile.
Right.
And his handlers. His administration, his handlers, the people that are actually doing the work and advising him. People can tell that because he gets up before he talks and he starts reading some of the stage comments and not exactly what he's supposed to read. He's not supposed to do that.
Right.
But he's when you get old like that, you start to slip. In general, you start to slip pretty fast. It's a very fast process, unfortunately. And some people are, they have much more longevity. Some people don't. And in his case, physically, you can see him degrading quickly, right?
Yeah.
You can see him degrading quickly. So I don't think if they would have him there in that position, that's for a reason. We do something called electronic voting. My personal opinion, I have no confidence in anything that goes through a computer. I do not. If you were to write me an email, right, you can't verify it by conversation. I have no confidence in the email until we talk.
Okay.
That's just me.
Okay.
Because anything on a computer can be manipulated.
Sure.
And when you get into that field, right, when you start doing that, and these guys, if you really look at them, it's almost like they're not worried about the election. But why are they making plans past the election? Now, I understand that President Biden just can't say, I'm not going to run.
No,
that'd
can't.
Be a big problem. He'd be a lame duck and everybody would jump off the, the ship. But if he were to, there's another candidate that caught my eye, right? because he serves the narrative that they have going. And I'll say it again, they're going to force what's going to change in the entire world.
Are we talking Newsom? Are we talking Gavin Newsom?
There we are. There we are. He did not hesitate to compliment President Biden. He was the first one to do that,
right?
Like that. That was overkill, right? And he did that with a straight face. And so when you have somebody like that that will read the script, he's compliant. He's very compliant.
Right.
And because he's compliant and because they're forcing the system, they're going to have in the White House who they want in the White House. I do suspect a total and absolute breakdown. I do. I suspect that total and absolute breakdown. There are too many Americans that will not. They're not going to yield this election, right?
We're too
divided.
This
election is going to, well, it's going to hit the heart and soul of what America is. And they're seeing that, you know, when certain things come to light, they're going to see that slip away. They're not going to go for that. And so by, that's why we'll have more of a council than anything else. And also this Russia situation is going to play into that. The China situation is going to, these two countries are poised. And there's about to be, I hate to say this, there will be a big eruption in the Middle East in a very short time. A huge eruption. Something's going to go wrong in the Middle East, and it will affect the entirety of the world.
Is it because Israel seems to be, you know, look, we already know Israel's not liked by the world. We already know the United Nations has an agenda against them. But it looks like Israel is getting more aggressive in where they're going. Am I correct in that?
Well, also, and Saudi Arabia is going to be, if they're going to just be vaporized.
I mean,
they're not
that
be
isn't
there.
What? I mean, Mike, are you serious? Wait a minute.
They're just not going to be there.
Saudi Arabia is going to be vaporized. I mean,
they're going to be wiped up. They're not going to be there. They're not going to be there.
Okay.
They will be removed. They will be removed.
Is Iran going to do it? Is the United States going to do it?
You have a very fast reordering of the Middle East. Right. I mean, it's fast. They've already discounted the U.S. dollar. The dollar's not in the Middle East and some of their major exchanges. And these guys are making money. They have become wise. They said, hey, we have the oil. Right. And America's going to have to use their own. But we're setting our own prices without international, you know, oversight. So there's a breakaway community in the Middle East. It's becoming strong and it's powerful and it has a lot of money. The USA, we have everybody's money. That's why we have so much debt.
Right, right.
But we have everybody's money. The Middle East, they're kind of like Libya was before Gaddafi died. That country was unbelievable. It was, they did not portray Libya for what it was in the news. They were not going to do that because Gaddafi was not the person people think he was. He really was. Anyway, that's a dead story. But
well, can you,
yeah, the Middle East is
a time bomb.
Middle East,
yeah,
it is, and it's just not with these factions forming up, with Israel now being emboldened to do, when like we discussed before, Israel's going to have to do what they have to do, or it's either they do an offensive, or bring all their defenses to bear against what will come against them. Somebody's either going to strike them with a deadly blow, or they're going to have to take out what will strike them with a deadly blow. Either way, it's not going to bode well for Israel, because Israel has no allies.
Right.
Zero. No allies.
Right.
And for first time in history, Israel has zero allies. The UK is they've withdrawn favoritism.
Right. Right.
They've done this. The king there has done this. The USA has done the same thing. We're quite shallow at the UN. And the Middle East is just waiting to get her out of the way. But the problem with that is they now have the technology to back up all their threats. Every single threat they've given, they now have power to back it up, right? In order for them to be totally effective, they have to absorb Saudi Arabia. So it will be removed. They will take what they need to take. And then we're going to see things go to a brand new level. With warfare. In the meanwhile, the USA, we're not going to be able to do anything because we're about to see politics go to a brand new level where things will be locked up. They're just going to be locked up. Nobody's going to care about executive orders and things
like
that.
Nobody's going to care. Already, already Biden was supposed to release some information Sunday, and he was ordered to. I mean, the deadline came. The Congress is already it's done. He's got to hand it over. He just didn't do it. I just don't feel like it. It don't matter. I mean, it's sort of like we don't have a constitution anymore. It seems like that they just do what they want. There's no rules. They're calling the shots as they go. It's quite interesting. Let me ask you about Macron, because this thing is out of control, Mike. I mean, we all know it was the boy was shot there and all that. But this is deeper than that, isn't it? I mean, this is the migrants who are really the ones in the streets burning down France. And I don't think that Macron understands or wants to understand what's going on.
Which is why he might want to watch out for Iran, right? We're going to have a repeat. And Macron might want to watch out for Iran. Most of those groups that are over there, by the way, are they're paid quite well by Iran, right?
Right.
Same ones were in Europe. Same thing. But they have not coordinated some of their larger strikes yet. The UK, they need to watch out big time, too. Anybody who has open nuclear facilities, better not, they need to beef up security quickly. We do, too, because these terrorists that are around the globe are silent. They're silent for a reason. They're watching everything. They're inserting themselves. And when they strike, it'll be a major blow. It really will be. And it's so sad because you have certain agencies that are hunting, but they're very difficult to find. Here's the problem. When people need money, but you have countries out there that will pay a citizen of a different country $10 million for information. What kid would not go for that? And then you have TikTok and all the social media stuff where people are making $50,000 a week. Right. So you get one of those guys or somebody wants to aspire to do that, and they start paying these guys that type of money. What kid is going to say no if they think, hey, this is free money? These kids are not thinking about how the world works. Their world is inside of social media.
Yes, it is.
By consensus, they see right and wrong and what is real and what is not. These kids are going for everything.
So you're saying that we're not just dealing with Edward Snowden's anymore or whistleblowers, but we're dealing with just flat-out bribery. Just being paid by governments to information and send it to them, period.
That's right. That's why the CIA and the FBI were involved. That's why Elon Musk found out that the CIA and FBI were paying, that social media company he bought. And some more social media companies are finding out that you have agencies that pay them, right? Because they understand this is a major communication line. Right. But kids are sophisticated. They come up with these little code words and everything else. And they're starting to think well outside the box, which is tasking. Most folks, that's right around the corner, right? There are emergency powers set up for 2023. Emergency powers.
By who? By
the United States of America.
Okay.
Coordinated with Germany and the UK and all these. This is outside the UN, right? The UN is normally humanitarian things and global police, right? Policing. But this is outside of them. And you kind of get that gut feeling that something is too much attention, too much money, too much coordination being thrown in one direction by all sides, right? So they're not letting the populace understand the state of world affairs. World affairs are not what they're portraying on major, mainstream media. And if people don't get their news from an alternative source and then really do their homework to see what they can trust and what they can, they're going to be misinformed and they're going to be angry
when you
things
can't go,
actually start to
you
happen.
You can't just watch the 6 o'clock news by the local network or cable networks. You're just going to, that's all propaganda. Whether it
or
left, it's all propaganda.
That's
right. And the real.
It's a bunch of noise.
It's a bunch of noise. And they're just the cocaine in the White House. To me, that is just nothing but noise. That's just
it is
a show. It's a distraction.
Well, you have Soros's Soros' son, right? He's going to lay off 40 employees. He's been making consistent visits to the White House. And so he's going to take up a lot of attention. But these guys are forcing in everything, all new policies and everything else. In my opinion, they're setting up for the beast to walk forward. Those, the doors are going to open. This guy's coming out, right?
Yep.
As far as government people that truly do matter, they're almost gone. There's nobody left who really matters. And what I'm saying is, everybody take a look. Isn't it like we only have, well, I want to say, you know, fifth floor people at the White House? They shouldn't be there. That's what it seems. It seems like a bad movie. Like they shouldn't be there.
You're saying the people running the show should be on about the fifth floor, okay? Staffers.
Yeah, they shouldn't be there. What is this? It does not seem real. And,
no, it don't.
You know, we had this discussion a long time ago that when the important people that really care about this country are gone, they went underground. They can't come topside, right?
Yeah, you're right.
And believe me, they have vast underground accommodations.
Yeah.
And when they go down there, you're talking about five-year preparation just to get down there. They're not coming back up here.
They're not coming back.
And they would only go down there if they were within a 10-year period of some huge major event. So we're right there in the window right now.
How many
that
people?
That means they're going to leave.
How many people are how many people are these under, I mean, I've talked to a truck driver who drove down and delivered in deep in the Appalachian Mountain, Pennsylvania area, 2 miles, 3 miles down there, and he just dropped the trailer. He went in. There was a huge cafe. He sat down. He said there must have been 500 people eating lunch with trays while they were unloading his truck. An hour later, a man come back, said, "You're ready to go." He got in his truck, drove out of there, and the next day, $15,000 in his bank account. And
he was on the outskirts.
Yeah,
so
he's just
that.
He's just the guy.
Imagine that.
Yeah. So how many people are in these facilities? These kids, they're like cities, aren't they?
Could you imagine an elevator the size of a 3-bedroom house?
That's an massive. Elevator. A massive.
Yeah. And that's for people, not for vehicles, right? That's just for people to make their trip down there. So you get on there and you get yourself comfortable for about, 15, 20 minutes straight down, right? And when you come off, I can only tell you about one part, but when you come off, it's like looking at New York City. That's what it's like.
What? So is it modern? I mean,
Oh, yeah. It's vast. It's just vast. It's mind blowing. And part of the problem is people look at the Earth, right? They look at the Earth. They look at the surface, but they never look at the ratios, like an actual depiction of the surface compared to the sky, compared to the oceans. Because if they did, they would be astounded to say, "What? We're living in that little hair width line." If you draw a circle of the Earth on a regular sheet of paper, right? The pin, you know, the pin mark that goes around in a circle, that one pin mark that covers a radius, we live and fly airplanes on that little pin mark. So look how huge the Earth is. Look how huge it is.
It's not flat.
Right?
Not
That's
flat.
Huge. No. That means, you know, 25,000 feet is still within that pin mark. When we dig underground, it's still within that pin mark. The oceans are still within that pin mark. But then you go down from there, right beneath that, you have these large caverns. Some of these caverns have a 3,000 to about 15,000 foot ceiling, right? And then below that, then you start some of the earth things. That's why when they dug down, they tried to dig into the center of the earth. They stopped at a certain point and hit a void. And then they hit this impenetrable place where they couldn't go any further. They did this 12, 13, 14 times. They still do it today. They hit an impenetrable barrier they can't get near. So all this stuff about the Earth's core is theorized. It's not real. They don't know that for fact. All they can do is judge what's on the top side. You can't get down.
There's no way.
You can't do that. So everything is theorized. You go to the bottom of the ocean, you start seeing stalactites and stalagmites upside down. You go in, there are oceans within oceans within oceans. The deeper you, can you imagine going down into a sub? And they say, okay, we're going to go into the lake. You go into the lake and everything is inverted, right? Then you go even deeper and everything is, it's just all wrong. Then you start seeing structures shouldn't be down there, like depictions of very large creatures, etchings. And you're not supposed to have etchings down there. You don't go deep down into the ocean, 10 miles. You don't do that and have etchings, right?
No.
So something is wrong.
Etchings. Are you saying, wait a minute, are you saying like civilizations drawing?
Like, yeah, they're covered over by this stuff that looks like, I don't know, it looks like crystal has formed on it.
Yeah,
right?
Okay.
But clearly, somebody made that stuff down there. We're talking structures.
Well, you mentioned Leviathan's kingdom.
All sorts of
you
things.
Mentioned Leviathan's kingdom last week, which Leviathan's in the Bible. He's real. He's got a kingdom of demons. There's sea demons.
Yes,
am I right?
That's a kingdom. That's a kingdom. Real kingdom.
So we talk about, and this webinar is coming up, folks, aliens above and below. What we're talking about here is that when you're dealing with the prince of the power of the air, Lucifer, but you have to realize there was his minions, his fallen angels were on this planet, and they're still on this planet. They didn't die.
They never left.
They never left. No, they can't go back to heaven, and they're reserved in the ground. They're being held down, but they're going to come out of there. They're not going to stay there forever.
Pastor Paul, see that. But look, that period where you said they're not going to stay down there, evidently something is happening. And
okay.
This is the unfortunate part.
Okay.
Here's a small piece of experience. These things, all these little orbs people get excited about, not the tic-tac, right? Not these floating ball things they see, but the real craft, right? This is going to sound real strange, but people are going to hear it again. When these things come out of the ocean, people on the beach, right? Normally, like Port Orb, California, a long time ago, doing a run on a beach, a bunch of guys were on a beach doing drills where you can't really run, right? You're really tired. You only get 3 feet when you take 20 steps. And this thing comes out of the water, huge. And then out of that comes these flying people, like big, ugly people, right? And they're harmless the entire time, communicating this one message. Don't worry. The entire time, don't worry, right? Everything feels different. It feels like you're in a high fear state. It feels like a dream. Your ears are buzzing and everything else. They don't do a thing, right? They observe, go back. You don't see them again. They do this all the time. Normally, when people actually see things like that, it's what they're seeing, right? But on this particular occasion, and I hope this, I'm pretty sure this story will get out. An old man comes out. He's about 9.5 feet tall. He's got something in his hand. Everywhere he points, the creature goes. Everywhere he points this little handheld thing, the creature goes. It looks like a big dog or something like that. And he tries to coax people, right, to come back with him. Inside the hole he comes out of, like a portal or whatever it is, inside that portal are the ugliest, smelliest, nastiest things you ever saw in your life, right? That will start happening all over the place. Totally harmless, they present themselves, right? But who knows what happens on the other side? And but the number of these encounters will no doubt increase. And when people begin to encounter this stuff, I mean really encounter. See, a lot of people, they like the end times, but the reality of the end times is that we're going to have to deal with the spiritual elements.
It's going to be
that
ugly.
that have been partitioned. We've been protected this entire time. They
yep.
cannot do what they want to do. We've been protected. That protection is coming. It's going away.
We know in the Bible, it tells us that these fallen angels have been reserved into everlasting chains of outer darkness, reserved until the day of judgment. In other words, there's a day they get turned loose. Now, it says in Revelation 9:11, the book I'm writing, of course, it tells you that Apollyon, God sends the angel down with the key. I think CERN's trying to open
right.
it, but CERN's not going to get
they
it
can.
Open.
They can't. No, not until they. Because you have the fallen angels, the 200 that fell on Mount
200,
Hermon.
Mount Hermon.
They
right?
can't escape. They're bound. They nope. can't escape. But there were one third fell with Satan. So the Earth has only encountered back then the 200 on Mount Hermon and reserve. But you're still dealing with the rest of them. In the Book of Revelation, it says. you know, Satan fell that wound to the inhabitants of the earth and
that's
of
right.
the sea, for Satan is coming. So we're dealing with the rest of the big ones.
Yeah.
Now, they can't do anything because of the protective barrier. And that protective barrier was given to us by Christ.
Thank
if it were
Jesus.
Not for believing Christians, this earth would not have a protective barrier. Right. Even when it comes down, we still have it. I know that for a fact.
Amen.
Right? We still have it.
Amen.
So, but the sheer knowledge of seeing these things, it's like a nightmare. You know, when you have a nightmare, no matter if you're covered by the blood of the Lamb or not, you may go through your emotional period, and then you recover by saying, wait a minute, I'm covered by the blood. I'm okay. It was just a dream. In this case, it's the exact same thing. Right?
Right.
The way I was actually taught to overcome something by overcoming any nightmare. Realize what you're doing all the time. Leave nothing to chance, right? And if you can go into a dream with your identity, you've done it. That means in any given scenario, you're going to evaluate that scenario without giving yourself over to that compromise of emotions. But most people, if they've taken things for granted, especially their Christianity, they may be a little weak in that area. And this is what comes with the end times.
What about the training that you and others have received? And I'm sure that we know about MK Ultra. We know about some of these programs, but remote viewing, and there's all kinds of different things. But have soldiers been trained to deal what's coming from the pit?
They have.
Okay.
Yes, they have.
What kind of training is that?
Okay, you go through a training of your body first, right?
Okay.
Which means they're going to beat the pulp out of you.
Okay.
So you can learn to overcome certain body functions. You know, keep your body under control.
Right.
And understand that it's just a body. It does not touch you. So one of the first things you learn is that you are not your body, right? You still exist. Your body is separate from you, but you control that body. Well, most people, they don't know that, right? They think they are their body. They look in the mirror. They say, that's me. I look in the mirror and I say, well, thank you, Lord. Let me go on about the day because this body is under my submission as I submit to the Most High. The other thing are mental tests, right? Awareness is key.
Mm-hmm.
Awareness is key because awareness is identity. For example, if you can open your eyes for 1 second, look at a place you've never seen before and shut them, learn to recall everything you saw. What that's going to actually do is make you become aware of detail, especially about yourself, right? So remembering who you are is key. But before you remember who you are, the one thing they'll ask you is, who are you? And you know, most people can't give an answer. They cannot give an answer. Once you know who you are, and that's the establishment of your own character, right? You have to know what you like and what you dislike. You have to know what your objectives are.
Yes.
And what your objectives are not. You have to know your own character and what your character is not. Most people can't answer that right off the bat. Once you do that, the nature of your dreams will change. In a dream, you know, sometimes in a dream, you don't know who you are. You accept whatever environment you're put into, right?
Right.
That changes. Once you have this training, once you do self-identification, the nature of your dreams will change. Because you're actually accepting what you're made to be, who the Father made you to be. And in my case, right, I had to remind myself, because you sometimes in a dream, you forget you're a child of the Most High.
Absolutely.
Your royalty, right? Your royalty and training. And it's very
It's
real.
A mindset.
So in a dream.
It's
it
a
is.
Mindset. You have to get in that mindset, whether you're conscious or unconscious, whether you're awake or asleep.
That's right.
Allowing.
That's right.
And would you say that's allowing the spirit man in you to be in control, even if your body's sleeping, even if you're relaxed?
That's it.
That's a faith walk, really. And it's also bringing your body into subjection, bringing your mind, your will, and emotions into subjection.
Right.
Christians
because
can do
if
that.
You can, yeah. Because if you become emotionally compromised, right, most people serve their emotions. And what I mean by that is, if they get angry, they respond to anger. If they get happy, they respond to that happiness. By the way, happiness is temporary. Joy is eternal. If they respond to these emotions,
right,
that's a compromise, right?
Right.
But discipline is to be happy, but still evaluate, still understand who you are, your objectives, what the Lord would require of you, and then act on spiritual things, never by the flesh, right?
Oh, no.
You give the flesh one little inch, you slip one time,
right?
And your body will crave that power again. You can take power away from all your natural reactions, right? Because without the spirit, we're animals.
Amen.
It is by way of the spirit that we, you know, tamper down our flesh, right? We cast out thoughts and imaginations that may exalt themselves above the Most High. That's actual training in certain areas of the military. In fact, there are certain areas of the military where you go on certain patrols and areas. If you're not truly a Christian, you can't be on those teams because you will not come back.
Yeah, that's really important. No, you have
you will
faith
not survive.
In the Most High.
And then there, for the most part, there are areas that if you are a Christian, you can forget ever having a career higher than a specific point.
Yeah.
Point blank.
They don't want you
there. There have been guys that got up to a colonel and then they would come out with their Christianity and all of a sudden they're sitting at home, right?
Yeah.
So you can only go up so far. But there are bases you cannot go on to and mention the name of Jesus, and you have to sign something for that.
Wow.
Lots of places like that. You have to sign.
Wow.
Because if you mention the name of Jesus, you disrupt everything they're doing there. If you go into an underground base, you're not going to mention the name of Jesus. There are no, you're not going to have a chaplain that's going to mention Christ,
right,
there, which
right.
is why they push this universal authority now, even in those places. This weird kind of religious setup. Probably why they're burning all the churches and taking them down.
Yeah, it's a demonic plan. Can I ask you about clones for a minute? I mean, this is just off the, I know it's off the subject, but people really want to know.
Are there clones?
Yeah, are there clones of human beings?
Hitler successfully cloned people.
Hitler?
Hitler did, yes.
Joseph Mengele and these guys.
He sure did. The Russians successfully cloned people. They cloned them. But they know how to do things, right? Because let's go ahead and face it in geology, not geology. When you're looking up these ancient cities and all the tablets and everything, they got all the good stuff, Pastor Paul. You know, the priests of Egypt actually knew some things by way of the fallen angels.
Okay.
In Saudi Arabia, they actually knew some things by way of the fallen angels. They not only corrupted mankind, but they corrupted life, period, on earth by having a person volunteer to have their body taken over by something else, right?
That's not good.
So it's like a transfer of that spirit into a person. These New Age people call it consciousness, but it's in fact your spirit, right? So their spirits would take over your body while you would be exiled into their limbo, whatever that meant. You had to agree to it. Right, it's almost like you agree to go to hell while they're doing whatever the case is. These days, when they did the cloning in Germany, for example, the Vril Society actually had that knowledge. Right, they did it with they cloned animals.
Yeah,
they cloned a couple of human beings, and one of the problems they had with the human beings is that they were incredibly violent when they, you know, when they would come to themselves. They had no real identity, so they learned how to do rituals to have something
so they
go into
to
that body.
Did they not have a? Did they have a soul?
No, they had to have something to go into that body.
Yeah,
right.
So
they
that's a demon. Well, that's a spirit of some sort.
Yeah,
some...
there you go. So now, but think of this: how many people are on Earth that could have been, because they manufacture babies now? But how many people were engineered and are now, you know, have a demonic entity in them? You run across
walking
a really
right
smart
now?
Individual, right?
Yeah.
Really smart individuals. I don't trust smart individuals, but they do not like the name of Jesus Christ, because if they will not come near you, you can always tell who they are, because you'll start to recoil internally. It's almost like the Lord allows you to see right through it. Right now, as far as a hole in the head, you know how they say they got a little hole in the middle of their eyes. Look, I got one of those. I can't go to India I was in a service, and when I was in doing some service things in India, Pastor Paul, they made me come back. They said, you can't be over there. That it's disrupting people, because I have a hole right there. And they said, well, it's your third eye. No, it isn't. What are you? I don't need a third eye. You know, I'm spiritual.
Yeah, you were using the anointing of the Spirit of God, and your ability to discern was driving them nuts, because they disrupted.
Well, and they also saw a physical. See, I have this indention on my head.
Yeah.
Right between the noggin. Right. Anyway, they saw that, and they thought it was a reincarnation of one of their things.
Well, you was in India. Okay, so you actually have an indentation, right? You have a.
So when they look, and it's not just an indentation, but it's shaped a certain way, right? So that just made it worse.
They thought you was some kind of guru.
They did.
Well, you kind of are, Mike, in a way. I mean, come on, just a guru for Jesus.
A goofer? How about a goofer?
No. Yeah, I mean, look, I know. I was in India a couple times, and I know that they are very, extremely superstitious. In other words, if a baby's born deformed, they think it's a god.
Yeah, they have that 2.5, is that 24-inch? They have a 24-inch woman there. She's 25 years old. She's the smallest woman on earth.
They worship her.
That just mess you up. That'll mess you up if you see this. And she has an incredible personality, but she's 24 inches tall. That's it. And she walks around, and she's proportioned like a baby.
I see. But she's a grown woman. But she's a grown woman, right?
Yeah, she can never have kids. Her body is a body of a baby.
Yeah, she's crazy.
Right, so a walking baby. She's 24. Anyway.
I know. I seen when there was a baby.
And they drink rat milk.
What?
They let the rat.
Who? No.
Yeah, they do. They will sit there and do stuff like that. And then while I was over there, I almost fell into a river that looked like, it didn't look too good. And it was where a hotel was. How are you going to have a hotel near a river that's brown and green? That didn't look good.
Because most of the cities there, there's no infrastructure. There's no sewage structure.
Oh, so terrible. Oh, that's awful.
Yeah. Anyway.
But they don't mind. They bathe in it.
Yeah, I know.
Some people do anyway.
And that's why they get cholera and malaria and all these other things, because it's just. That's why I shouldn't drink the water. I did once. I got real sick. Don't ever do it. No, don't drink the water. No. All right, Mike. Now, as we're winding down here tonight, I appreciate the fact that you really shared a lot about this binary system, you know, that's obviously. Do you expect, between now and the end of the year, are there going to be major changes on this earth as far as weather, climate, wars? Do you, in the next 6 months, are we going to see, if this thing starts showing up and everybody can see it and they wonder what it is, and then we're not getting the truth from the governments of the world, but what do you see happening in these 6 month period? More disease, more war? What's coming?
Well, yeah, disease, yeah. Do you know they have a tree fungus, right? Another case. I believe this is case number 3 ever. A person has the fungus that was growing on a tree. That's not supposed to happen.
No.
That is not supposed. And that seems like it comes right out of a video game or something like that, right? I believe that one of those doctors likened it to some kind of release of something people were watching, but a fungus of a tree, which is deadly to human beings, it grew on his leg. And they had to do surgery to get the fungus out. And they had to send him through a treatment for 2 weeks, a bath. He was immersed for 2 weeks to get the compounds out, to get all that stuff out. So there are more and more cases of that showing up. That's ridiculous, because that's, you know, for a tree to breach its own biological barriers and go straight to a human being. Okay. You know, it's bad enough that they do have certain plants that cry if you break a leaf or something like that. And it's bad enough that they have plants. If you have a plastic plant near it, it will start growing in the shape of the plastic plant, right? It can mimic other plants.
Oh, really?
It'll look like other plants. Yeah. So it could be an artificial plant, and it will. It, you could set it 9 feet across the room, and within 2 weeks, it's going to look just like that plant. right? Well, so it mimics the foliage around.
I know that if you have plants growing too close together, that, a lot of times they will literally merge and become a new species. Grow branches. You know, you could have two different types of plants, and they can.
Well, this one will change its leaves, Fastball.
It'll look like the other one.
Yes, it will.
Camouflaging itself in its environment.
It'll do it perfectly, and it does not care if it's artificial or whatever. But my question is, how in the world can it do that when it's, you know, you stick a plastic plant outside your window, but it can see it? What is that? Some photoreceptor we missed? What? Well, anyway, so you have things like that. So God's, disease.
Well, Heidi told me all the time. She said, "Paul, you can walk up to plants and talk to them."
Yeah, they do. They do communicate,
and they will communicate, and they will.
They do communicate.
And they will, look better. They'll feel better. They'll be healthier if you just talk to them, and water them. But you know, talk to them and tell them how beautiful they are. Tell them how great they are, and they'll actually do better.
They do communicate.
Yeah.
And they do seem to, they do show emotions. It's almost like they talk with a voice just like you and I, but it's at a much higher frequency.
We should expect that,
Mike. At the same volume. They speak at our same volume on a higher frequency.
The Book of Psalms tells us that the leaves of the trees clap their hands and give praise unto God. I mean, really, it says that. It tells you that. Yeah. So we just blow past that stuff.
Here's one thing I hope. I saw a paper back in 1986, right? I'm not joking. They were looking at five trees, right, that uprooted this guy's house and ran in the middle of the forest and left a trail, five trees. Okay, that's a report. That was an actual report.
The trees got up and ran?
The trees got up.
Whoa, Mike! Whoa! Oh, wait,
what is that? What is that? What in the world is that? I hope that's not. I hope that's not the case. You're talking about it was. How tall did they say that tree was? That tree was 86 feet tall or something. Like those trees were like 86 feet.
That's huge.
That they were spontaneously moving is what the report said, and they did uproot themselves and they were in different locations. They verified that the trees were no longer there and that those same trees were sitting in the middle of the forest, and they verified the trail. Now how they got there, I don't know. That was in the report. The report was the guy was so scared he never went back to his home. Him and his family never went back to that house.
Well, I suppose I wouldn't either if a tree.
They never went. They never ever went back.
Maybe when we get to
heaven. Is that weird?
Yeah.
I think the Lord has. He didn't tell us everything.
No,
obviously.
He didn't.
But I think there are some things in store. One of my greatest concerns is that, Pastor, we're in the end times, and as this object you keep talking about, right, the closer it comes, it seems like people are losing it. People are losing it. Things are happening. Right? Phenomena is happening. Whoever thought that a day would come when the Pentagon is discussing, little green men, whoever thought that would come? I know they're Nephilim, right? They're Nephilim like that, but they're discussing little green men. They actually, these people who have been in contact with these things, right? They will tell you right now they've been in contact with them.
Yep.
They'll tell you right now. Although most of the clear ones are us, that's our stuff like that. Tic Tac, that's ours. We do that. We own the Tic Tac. But some of these other things that you see, they're not us, right? All these kids that see them, these tiny kids that say, you know, some giant people got off this egg. That's what they'll say. And that stuff. We have actually come to that day. And there's been another encounter, just like the one in Nevada. So,
there's been another one. Been another one.
Yeah, it's been another one.
Well, Mike, another one. Look, we've this webinar that's coming up, Aliens Above and Below. I can't wait to hear about you talking about Leviathan, Leviathan Kingdom, and all the things going on. We just got Avi Loeb. Heidi was able to get Avi Loeb, the Harvard professor who just found those spheres, metal spheres we talked about last week. He's gonna be one of the speakers on the webinar.
Is he still tracking Oumuamua?
Yeah, he's still tracking Oumuamua.
Is he?
Yeah.
Didn't it something recently, didn't it?
It did. And I'm going to ask him about that and those spheres, because those spheres are perfectly round and they're made up of exotic metals. Okay. So
didn't they found some in Jakarta too, didn't they?
I don't know.
I believe they found some in Jakarta.
Well, I'll have to ask him that. I'm going to dig deep into him. We're also, of course, we look forward to what you're going to tell us for sure. And, also, we just got Ellie Marzulli said he's on board. He's going to be interviewed. He's got some new information for us. Rex Bear's got some new information for us. And then I'm also trying to get Stan Day on him, which we know he'll probably say yes. And there's a guy on the History Channel, actually on this show, Ancient Aliens, that we're going to try to bring on and give him his chance. So it's a combination of people, different perspectives, but we're not afraid to take this on, because I believe that these Nephilim and the fallen ones are going to become ever more prevalent in the last days than ever before.
Yeah, they're going to be quite intrusive, especially for us. You know, they don't want us in their system, right? They don't want us included, and so we know that mentally, supernaturally, they're going to try and make us corrupt ourselves as best they can. So it's a good, that's a good program. So if people have that defense by way of information, they can keep their sanity.
That's,
you know,
right.
They can't believe everything, but I'll tell you something, the spiritual manifestations are going to be 100% real.
Amen.
100% challenging. And without Christ, there is no protection.
No.
I think people are going to come to that conclusion quite quickly. There
Amen.
Is no protection outside of the blood of the Lamb. There is none.
Amen.
Because we can encounter all sorts of things, right? It could or could not be true. I saw things with my own eyes to this very day. I can't tell you if it were real or not. I can tell you about the report or something like that. I didn't see those trees. I just read about that.
Right.
But
you've
I
seen
saw
some
that
stuff.
On somebody's desk.
Yeah.
But I've seen stuff right in my face, Pastor Paul, and I'm telling you right now, even if people were to right now to see one, if they knocked on the front door, they cannot tell you if it's real or not.
Wow.
They can't. Something happens to you, and you cannot tell anybody that you 100% saw what you saw. It's almost like something in you says no, you know, just a blank no. But a day is coming where the protection is taken off, and at that point, all of us who love the Lord are going to realize that we've been protected all this time. I believe it's going to increase our faith. I do.
Amen.
Because when a person realizes that the Lord has been protecting us this entire time, you're talking about a faith boost, right? A real faith boost. But for other people, you know, without Christ, they don't have a chance. But at least some of us being around will be able, strong enough, you know, in the Lord to give that last call, because even during that time, I don't believe it's going to be too late until the wrath pours out, and we'll be, you know, no, we're not appointed to his wrath, meaning if we're not appointed to it, we're not going to be here during his time of wrath.
Amen.
There's a time of tribulation and a time of wrath, and a time of wrath makes tribulation look like a party. So those people left in the time of wrath have no hope. No chance, no anything. They're doomed. Their torment starts right then.
We don't want to be there. We're going to follow the Jesus Christ. We're going to stay in the blood of the Lamb, and we're going to be ready when he comes. We're ready when he comes. Mike, appreciate it. A lot of stuff for me to digest this week, but we look forward to being back with you next Thursday night, Lord willing.
Will do, Pastor Paul. Stay alert for the weather.
I will. It's going to be kind of dangerous. We're going to watch it.
Yes, it will. Yes,
I'll do
it.
We'll be talking about it probably next week. God bless.
We probably will. God bless, Pastor Paul. Okay. It's always an honor.
The honor's mine. God bless. Mike from the world. I told you it'd be mind-blowing tonight. Some of it just blows my mind. But then again, when I look into the Word of God, I can find the answers. And this heaven-shaking situation is true. How God does it, I'm not sure. If he's using this binary system or some other way, or just his voice alone, it's coming. The question is, are you saved? Am I saved? Have we been washed in the blood? Are we ready to meet the Lord? We're going to meet a lot of things in life. You're going to encounter things in these end times you never dreamed you would. But what if you encounter these things without Christ, without salvation, without any protection? With you're not under the protection of Psalms 91. You're not under the shadow of the Almighty. Where do you stand if Apollyon comes out of the pit? Are you saved? Would you be able to make it if Jesus was to come tonight? Would you be left behind, or would you be ready to go? I want you to type right now, I want to be saved. I want to be saved. Let me pray with you tonight, please. Let's get everything washed in the blood. Let's get ready to go.
I remember the night I first gave my life to Jesus. I was lost and all alone and so undone. There were pieces of me here, pieces of me there, and I was so broken. Then I asked Jesus, can you put me back together again? I know where I am now. You came to me and you saved me and turned my life around. And I know where I was then, Lord, and I know where I am now.
Oh, that's right.
You know, this walk in life, it's full of many decisions. And we live with each and every one we make. But the best decision I ever made was when I asked the Lord.
Think about it, folks.
Can you come and heal this broken man that I am? And I know where I was then. I know where I am now. He came to me and you saved me and turned.
I know where I am now.
And I know where I was then.
I know where I am now.
You came to me and you saved me. You turned my life around. And I know where I am now.
This is the Salvation Station, folks.
I know where I was then, Lord.
People are wanting to be saved.
And I know where I am now.
There are people getting saved tonight that I'm going to pray with. They're accepting Christ as their Savior. I'm going to play one more song. If you still are out there, you're watching. There's over 6,000 people still here. And if you're out there, I want you to know God loves you. I want you to know that Jesus said, the Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but by him all can be saved. I'm going to play a song right now by off the brand new album, Formerly Jacob. Wow. What a beautiful song this is. The Final Price. Or The Price Final. Just type, I want to be saved. I'll pray with you. This album is at my website if you want to get a copy. It's brand new. 13 songs. Formerly Jacob. Powerful.
If I knew that I would be betrayed, that a single kiss would seal away my fate, in the dead of the night I'd be beaten and bound for no fault of my own and taken away. If I knew
beautiful song by written by Jeffrey Clare Coper, sang by Jeffrey Clare Coper, of course, formerly Jacob. You can get this CD. It's at my website at paulbegleyprophecy.com. I'm going to pray with these folks that want to be saved right now. Some are rededicating. Main thing is people are calling on the name of Jesus and giving their life to the Lord. And he already paid the price for you and for me. Father, in the name of Jesus, tonight I repent of my sins. I confess them to you, Lord. And I call upon the name of Jesus. I ask you, Lord, to set me free, to break the chains, to break the chains the devil has tried to put on me, and the sin of the world that's tried to destroy me. And I'm asking now, as I repent of my sins and confess my sins to Jesus Christ, I'm calling upon the Lord for my redemption, for my salvation, for my hope, for my reality of being a child of God. Thank you, Lord. I am calling out on your name because I believe, I believe, I believe, I believe, and I receive Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. I believe Jesus died on the cross for the sins of the world. I believe that Christ rose from the dead. I believe that he ascended to heaven. And I believe he's coming back again soon and very soon. And I want to be saved. And I want to receive Christ as my Savior. So right here, right now, tonight, by faith, in God's grace, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name, I am saved, I'm saved, I'm saved, I'm healed, I'm delivered, I'm set free, I'm born again, I'm saved in Jesus, saved in Jesus, saved in Jesus' precious name. Praise God. Are you serious? Wow. Wow. Welcome to the family. Kevin Wilson, I love you still. Welcome to the family.
You start out strong to conquer the world. One boy and one pretty girl. It don't take long till your strength is wearing thin. Oh, just kiss her lips and sing it once again. Life is a roller coaster ride. Yeah, just hop on board, honey, for the lows and the highs. Life, it's a Ferris wheel. When the ride's all over, I'll love you still. 5 years in, here comes baby Jack. It's a wonderful day.
God bless you, Jeffrey.
Yes, she gonna be now the world's greatest mom. She says he looks a lot like you. Yeah, boy, ain't this fun.
Life is a roller coaster ride.
You just hop on board, honey, for the lows and the highs. Life, it's a Ferris wheel. When the ride's all over, hey, I'll love you still.
I will.
Now it's grandkids and late evening drives. Just another day in the park for a husband and wife. Oh, yeah.
Hey, Renee. Hi, Renee.
Life is a roller coaster ride. Yeah, just hop on board, honey, for the lows and the highs. It's a bad
still.
Kevin Wilson, beautiful song. Wrote that song for his wife, actually, but it's on his brand new album, Soul Seekers. And it's good to know that what puts marriages together, what makes marriages stay together, what makes life really worth living is having the love of God in your hearts. True love can be experienced by all when you've received the true love of Christ. It just works. Okay, guys, tonight we're letting you go. Our offer tonight, of course, is Concerned. And if you'd like to get a copy, it's seven DVDs, very powerful webinar we did called Concerned. I speak on the Beast Kingdom, Standeo. It's an incredible presentation. When I interviewed him, he talks about the New World Order and the Mark of the Beast. But this guy tells you, I didn't know this, Standeo is a former FBI agent. That when he worked on the Mark of the Beast technology, and when he found out, he got saved, and they realized he was helping make the technology for the Mark of the Beast. He then exposed it and left America for 30 years. Incredible guy. What a brilliant guy. Mike Brown the World. The end has come. The end has come. What a great hour conversation with him. Doug Hagman, Dangers of the World Economic Forum. Boy, does he expose it in this one. Unbelievable. Bishop Larry Ragland, CERN and the World Wide Web. Wow, he ties it together. Did you know that the World Wide Web was made at CERN? It wasn't Al Gore. It was CERN. And Rex Baer, CERN and Occult Practices, as well as my son, B.C. Begley, Bart Begley's CERN, a documentary, the history of CERN. Great, great stuff. All of it here. Guys, the price, we reduced the price. Your love gift of $45 or more, I'll ship it to you. You don't even have to order it. Just send a love gift of $45 or more, and I'm sending you Concerned. Okay, are you concerned about CERN? Are you concerned? Or are you going to burn? Okay, so that's why I want to send it to you. Thank you. Lenny says, I just sent you $100, Pastor, so made up for the missing last month. Well, God bless you, Lenny. And guess what, Lenny? I'm going to send you a concern, okay? God bless you. We love you, brother. Amen. Guys, I'm going to let you go. I hope you enjoyed it. We had a huge crowd tonight. A lot of people coming to Jesus and Mike blowing my mind. But I'll try it again tomorrow, Lord willing. If that thing don't show up, I know Jesus will. God bless all of you. Good night, everybody. Are you serious?